Hi children, how are you all? Hope all are doing good. Okay, children, so tell me when your daily habits, like the daily routine or the daily things what you are doing. We can start from the morning, okay? So morning you have to get up, then you have to go to school. So for going to school you need to get up early. Isn't it? Will you get up early in the morning, children? Yes or no? Otherwise, your mother wants to come and call you many times. Wake up, get up, like that. Or will you get up early? Yes, you have to get up early. You have to rise early in the morning. Why? You have to go to school on time. So, you need to get up early in the morning. So, getting up early in the morning, it's a good habit actually, isn't it? Then soon after getting up, what you will do? Yes, on the bed itself you can pray. That is also a good habit. Afterwards, your mother will ask you to go and fresh up. Means you brush the teeth, isn't it? Brushing teeth morning and evening, night. Morning and night, after the dinner, at night, twice a day, brushing teeth twice a day. It's a good habit, isn't it? Then, after brushing the teeth, what will you do? You will take a bath. Yes, so bathing in the morning, it is also a good habit. Afterwards, you will dress up nicely. You should iron your uniform before itself, isn't it? That your parents will do. And you have to wear the uniform. You should look clean and tidy, isn't it? Yes. Then afterwards, what you will do? Yes. Now you got up early. Then you brush the teeth. Then you bathe and then you put the uniform. Then what else? Yes. Your mother combs your hair nicely. Then you should have your breakfast. After all these things, you will go to school. Maybe you go to school by bus, school bus, or your father drops you. Yes, so you reach the school on time. So reaching school on time is also a good habit, isn't it? Yes. So after reaching school, you go to your classroom. Your teacher will come and teach you lessons. You should listen to her carefully. Whatever teacher is telling, you should listen. That is also a good habit. You have many friends in the class, isn't it? So behave very nicely to them. You should talk very politely. You should not fight with your friends, isn't it? That's like a good child. Yes or no? Yes. Then whatever teacher is teaching, you should listen carefully. Then afterwards, again you go back to your home. You should do your homework daily. Daily lessons you should read, isn't it? So there are many good habits that you should follow. A child who follows these good habits loves by everyone. You learn good manners, good habits at home as well as at school. Yes, isn't it? So today we are going to learn about some good manners and habits that you should follow as a child. What all good habits and manners you should follow? So we are going to learn about lesson 16, good habits and good manners and habits. Today we are going to learn about this, good manners and habits, lesson 16. Okay, so I told you there are many good manners, good habits that you should follow, and many of you are following it, isn't it? As you said, you are getting up early, you are going to school on time, you're listening to your teachers, you're talking nicely to your teachers, your friends, everyone. When you see the teachers, will you greet them? Yes, you will wish them by saying good morning, good afternoon, isn't it? Yes. Suppose your uncle gave you a gift on your birthday. If someone giving you gift, or uncle or aunt, your auntie is giving gift, then what you will tell to them after receiving the gift? When you receive the gift from someone, you should say, yes, thank you, isn't it? You should say, thank you uncle, thank you auntie. You will say or not? Yes, that's like a good child. If you receive a gift from anyone, you should say thank you, isn't it? Yes. Now suppose you want the help from your friend or someone, okay, then what will you tell them? Suppose in the class you forgot to take your pencil and you want to take pencil from your friend. You want to ask a pencil from your friend. How will you ask? Rani, will you please give me your pencil if you have extra one? Can you please give a pencil to me? If you want water from your mother, can you please give a water glass of water, mama? So when you add please, it's a request actually. It's a good manner of talking. When you're asking something, when you're asking something from others, you can ask them in a polite way. Like please, can you please give me this? So please is another word. When we request others something, if you want something from others, you can tell, can you please give me your pencil? Can you please give me a glass of water? So asking like this, it is a polite way of asking. Then suppose you hurt someone. By mistake, you hurt your friend's leg or something like that happened. What will you say? Oh, sorry, dear, sorry. Isn't it? Yes or no? When you hurt someone, you should say sorry. You should say sorry. When you hurt someone, you should say sorry. So, thank you, please, sorry. These are called the golden words. Golden words. You have to use these golden words whenever you receive a gift from someone, when you want anything from others, when you hurt someone. Thank you, please, sorry. It is a polite way of telling or talking, isn't it? So along with the good habits, you should have some good manners like this. The way you talk in a polite way, talking very softly to others, not in a rash way. Should not be in anger and all while talking to others. You should talk very politely. Okay, so let's learn about good manners and habits today. Okay, let's read your course book now. Okay, children? Yes, lesson 16, good manners and habits. Let's warm up. Can you see the pictures, the image? You can see the image here. Yes. A girl is giving something to the boy. So that boy is telling, thank you. Yes. Second image. Yes, a boy is telling to the mother, please help me. Means please, can you give me a glass of water? Please help me. Then, third image. Yes, that boy is telling sorry to that girl. Maybe that boy hurted that girl. Or because of that boy is telling sorry. So, thank you, sorry, and please are golden words. What are these words, children? Yes, they are golden words. Thank you, please, Sorry, these three words are golden words. It is a good habit to use these words. Yes. If you use daily in your, when you talk with others, or when you get a gift from others, or when you hurt someone, or when you are asking some help from others, if you use these words, these golden words, then it is a good habit, we tell. Okay, it's a good habit of using these words. So if you are a good child, then you surely use these words. Which are these golden words, children? Yes, thank you, please, and sorry. It shows that we have good manners. If you follow this good habit, then everyone will tell, this child has good manners. Isn't it? Yes. We learn good manners and good habits from our parents at home. At home also we learn good habits and good manners. Your parents teaches you, isn't it? They'll ask you to get up early in the morning. They'll ask you to do the daily homework. They advise you in doing many things. If you do wrong, your parents will tell, no, this is wrong, you should not do it. Isn't it? So your parents also support you. They always with you to teach you good habits, good manners. And from our teachers in school. So we learn good manners or good habits not only at home but also at school. School teachers teaches us, isn't it? There also teachers will teach you good manners, good habits. How to behave in the class, how to behave, how to give respect to elders. Everything you learn in the school also, isn't it? You spend most of the time in the school. So there you can learn many things. Good manners, good habits, good behavior, everything you learn mostly at school. Yes or no? Yes. A child who has good habits and manners is loved by all. If a child has good manners and good habits, he or she is loved by everyone. Everyone will say, that girl is a very good child, or that boy is a very good child. Yes or no? Yes. If you want to be a good child, always follow these manners and habits. If you want to become a good child, if everyone wants to say good about you, then you have to follow this good habits and good manners. If you are behaving politely with others, if you have good habit and good manners, everyone loves you. Everyone loves you and they will tell, this child has good manners, she is a good child, he is a good child, Rahul is a good boy. Your teacher will tell, Diya is a good girl, Pinky is a good girl, Manu is a good boy. So your teacher will say, your teacher will appreciate you by telling that you are a good boy, you are a good girl. So you want that appreciation from teachers and also from all other people, right? Then you have to follow this good habits and good manners. So try to use these words, golden words. When you receive a gift from anyone, just tell thank you. Not only gift. Suppose anyone has... If you don't have a pencil in the class, maybe you ask your friend, can you please give me a pencil if you have any extra? So your friend is giving. After giving, you can tell thank you. That there also you can use thank you. Not only when you receive gift, isn't it? Because your friend helped you by giving a pencil. So you can tell her thank you. Suppose your book fell down, your friend came and she gave to you. That time also you can tell, thank you. Like that you can tell, isn't it? Yes. When you get inside a room. Suppose you want to go to a principal's room. Huh? You never get inside like Russian, you can't go there, right? Near the door, you can tell, Madam, may I come in? Huh? Sir, may I come in? You should ask like this. You should ask permission to go inside the room. So these are the some things that you should take care of, isn't it? Yes. So use these golden words whenever you get a chance. Then everyone will tell, ah, you are a good child. Yes. So which are the golden words, children? Thank you, please, sorry. These three are the golden words.